Okay, so at this point, I'd like to move to this task of defining an equidistant projection, which is going to involve creating a custom projection. And the main concept here is of a great circle. Now, let me just say that please don't think that these are great circles. That's not what I'm talking about. If we go to our layout view and so lines of longitude form great circles. They pass through the pole and then back around the backside in here. And the equator is a great circle. All the lines of longitude form great circles. Great circle is kind of like if you take a ball and rolled it perfectly across paint, you would define a kind of the stripe on the ball would be a great circle because it's kind of the circumference of the ball. And the idea is that whenever you measure distance on a spheroid, the path, the shortest distance between two points, is going to define a part of a great circle that would then wrap around and then come back. Does that make sense? So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to. Oh, is it going to bother? I like that one. Let's change this one. So I'm going to remove these guys for now, and I'm going to say, actually, this one I don't want flat core anymore. I'm going to go to the data frame, and I'm going to change this to say that what I'd like to have is an equidistant projection. And what we'd like to do then, if we went under projected and went under world, is we'd like to use this azimuthal equidistance. So I'm going to click on that and say OK. And that's going to probably create this kind of cool looking thing. And our circles are clearly still going to be distorted. But the idea is that now from the center of this, any straight line that we draw out from the center will represent a great circle. We can see it here on the equator, and we can see it on the prime meridian, and any other kind of line that we draw out from the center point will be tracing a great circle route, which that and what this means is that with the this is actually called an azimuthal equidistant projection, is we are able to preserve distance from the center of the projection to all other points on the Earth. So that's kind of handy, but what we'd like to do is, you know, there's North Korea over there. We'd actually like to have this centered on North Korea. So what we'd like to do is go under properties and change this central meridian and latitude of origin to be North Korea. So let's just go to our attribute table of the centroid, and I'm going to write these numbers down. I'm going to write down that my longitude is 127.172852, and that my latitude is 40.143468. And then what I'm going to do is go to the properties of this data frame, and then I'm going to go under here and say new projected coordinate system. And what I'd like to do is I'd like this to actually be the azimuthal equidistant. And my central meridian, I'm going to highlight and say I'd like this to be 127.172852. And I'd like my latitude of origin to be 40.143468. And I'm going to leave everything else. I'm just going to call this my kind of North Korea azimuthal equidistant. And I'm going to say, and I'm going to leave the datum and everything else the same. I'm just changing the projection, not the datum. And I'm going to say apply, okay, and I'm going to say okay. And what I should now get is this azimuthal equidistant projection that is now centered on North Korea. So what this means is that any point or that I measure, any kind of shape, line, or circle that I draw from this point should be the distance from this point. Now I'm not done. Because I've just done this projection on the fly by defining the properties of the data frame. What I need to do is change the way that this point is actually being stored. So if I was going to clean up my workflow here, it's not just creating a custom project, but I'm also going to have to I'm going to have to project the feature. So I'm going to grab this tool and say project, and there should just be project data management. So this is not project raster, this is just project. Project spatial data from one coordinate system to another. My input is going to be the centroid of North Korea. My output is going to be the centroid, and I'm just going to go lowercase, azimuthal. Wow. Equidistant, and then the coordinate system. And it would be nice if we could just kind of import that from a data frame, but I don't think you can. So we're gonna have to do this over again. Do you remember how I defined it? I went to new projected coordinate system. I called it the North Korea azimuthal equidistant. I chose the azimuthal equidistant. I changed the central meridian to 127.172852. And the latitude of origin to 40.143468. And I applied it and said OK. And I said OK. And I'm not changing the datum, so I don't have to do anything there. And I say OK, and it'll think and it'll complete. And now, if I inserted yet another data frame, which is going to look a little ugly because it's going to just plop it on top of there, so I'm going to go over to data view. And if I grabbed my centroid azimuthal equidistant and threw it in there, the projection would be, what do you expect? It's in the azimuthal equidistant. Okay, and so now, ready? This is going to be kind of fun. If I grabbed the world countries and threw it on here and turned it on and zoomed out to full extent, I get this pretty cool beach ball. It's taking a while because it's having to project a very large vector file on the fly, but there is the world from North Korea flattened, which is pretty cool, huh? So we're now at the point where if we drew a line or a circle from this point, it would represent the geographic distance. And we are well on our way. Do you recognize this guy? It's kind of fun to look at the world like this and this.